on whatever date your chapter might use for it, we will be saying goodbye to our outgoing theme of In Touch with Tomorrow. While not an easy one to make a design for, to decorate with, it was an important to look forward and think of how we will approach our future. Will it be with gusto, with plans, with fun and friendship, or will we look forward with trepidation?
No!
I hope that most of all of you will pick plans, fun, and friendship. We've begun a new approach to finding new members and building new chapters or existing chapters using nextdoor.com. That's interesting. Which is turning out to be very exciting to all who have used it and found success. We will always have fun, new ways to find new sisters. Then it's up to us to actually ask them so that we do have plans for the future. Now we turn our thoughts to the new thing, which will be, what aspect of our organization will it feature? For this new year, we have adapted the theme suggestion of Joanne Giles, member of Torchbearer Epsilon in Henderson, Nevada. Her original idea was, sew a quilt of friendship.
Oh.
This was my great-grandmother's quilt. Quilt of friendship, which we adapted. The new theme for the 2018-19 year will be a quilt of friendship. Anyone who quilts or appreciates quilting knows that they are an art form that is a sum of all of its parts. Each piece going with so many others that finally create both a work of art and a usable item that you can hang, wrap around you, and give to someone to save special memories. Our chapter sisters, for those of us who have sisters we know all over, are for us pieces in a very important memory quilt, one that warms and protects us, reminds us of happy and not so happy times, of the sisters who stood with us in happiness and times of loss, silly times. They are the quilt that makes up all the special moments in our lives. For those of us who've been in many years, we either have a quilt with a lot of small pieces and potentially a very intricate pattern, or we have a pile of mini quilts, perhaps each for a town, chapter, or whatever way we remember our experiences. So, Founders Day candlelighting ceremony. This ceremony, blah, 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 okay. Each year on April 30th, the Sisters of Beta Sigma Phi gather together and remember the founding of our organization over 80 years. It is a time to pay tribute to those who came before us. It is also a time to give thought to ourselves. Do we uphold their original value and vision? Do we seek a vision for ourselves? Let us light a candle as we remember the individual who brought us the experience of shared learning and friendship to last a lifetime. Let us light a candle for Walter W. Ross.
Torch.
Purple
eyes. Yes. Can't help but think David would be very proud.
Yes.
Should have turned that way first.
Oh, wow. True. Watch it. Going door to door selling encyclopedias in 1931, Walter Ross was moved by the many women he met who had been crushed by the Great Depression and had no opportunity for learning, and only limited opportunities to make social connections. Being a man of vision, he began to offer a series of study programs at the Sunflower Hotel in Abilene, Kansas. He called his program the National What to Read Club. He could have no idea that his small club would turn into a worldwide organization. He first presented his program to seven women who became our first sisters. Let us now remember these women: Alice Clover, Nada Chase, Helen Kessinger, Naomi Simpson, Arlene McClintock, Helen Clover Pepper, Marguerite Nelson. Shortly after his study group began to meet, Mr. Ross was traveling on business to Veneta, Oklahoma. His search for the most prominent woman in Veneta led him to Miss Leona V. Schroers, who was very interested in his program. The second chapter of the National What to Read Club was formed that very afternoon. Let us remember Leona V. Schroers. Let's also remember Sally Rogers McSpadden. Miss Schroers introduced Mr. Ross to Miss McSpadden, a sister of Will Rogers, and a woman very active in the National Federation for Women's Clubs. Today they formed the motto Life, Learning, and Friendship.
That's
the Greek
cool.
words and letters for that motto were discovered, and a Greek letter organization was formed, transforming a study club into a sorority. The sorority grew to meet the needs of its sisters over the years. Various degrees were added, ensuring that our organization did indeed keep the promise of being relevant for a lifetime. Along with these degrees came our beautiful rituals, which bind us together as a sisterhood. The first of these were written by a member who had been associated with Beta Sigma Phi since the beginning. Let us remember Lynn Terry. Also, let us remember ourselves. Each one of us is a masterpiece in the making. Let us recognize that the progress and development of our sorority did not end with those early founding members. One of the most remarkable qualities of Beta Sigma Phi is its ability to continue to develop both as a sisterhood and in us as individuals. Let each of us develop our lives into a living masterpiece and carry the light of the torch to others so that they may also enjoy the benefits of life, learning, and friendship. Let us continue to seek a vision for our sisterhood that will carry it into the new year. I am my sister. Happy